Hi all, today we can see about Maxwell's equations. It's a very important topic in electrodynamics. There are four Maxwell's equations. These four Maxwell's equations are based on the four basic laws that you have studied in your lower classes. These laws are Gauss's law for electrostatics, Gauss's law for magnetostatics, Faraday's laws of magnetic induction and Ampere's circuital law. Gauss's law for electrostatics states that the total electric flux over a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the net charge enclosed within the surface. Epsilon 0 is the permittivity in free space. And Gauss's law for magnetostatics is the total magnetic flux over a closed surface is equal to 0. The Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction states that the induced EMF associated with a coil is equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with it. And Ampere's circuital law states that the line integral of the magnetic field over any closed path is equal to mu 0 times the net current enclosed within the path. In deriving the Maxwell's equations, the physical quantities that are involved in these basic laws that we are writing in terms of some integrals. There are mainly three types of integrals we are using, that's line integral, surface integral and volume integral. The electric potential we can write as the line integral of the electric field. The current I is the surface integral of the current density J. And the charge Q is the volume integral of the charge density. So, with the help of these integrals, we are writing these laws in the integral form. Then we will use the basic two theorems in the mathematics, that are divergence theorem and Stokes theorem. These two theorems we have seen in the last video. In divergence theorem, the volume integral of divergence of a vector is equal to the surface integral of that vector over a surface which enclosing this volume. And Stokes theorem states that the surface integral of the curl of a vector is equal to the line integral of that vector over the boundary of that surface. Here we are using two more integrals. This electric flux is the surface integral of electric field and magnetic flux is the surface integral of magnetic field over a surface. So, with the help of these four laws, these integrals and using these two basic theorem in mathematics, we are going to derive the Maxwell's equations. Maxwell's first equation, it is based on Gauss's law. Gauss's law states that the total electric flux over a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the net charge enclosed within the surface. That is, total electric flux phi e is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 q. Now we can express this mathematical form of Gauss's law in the integral form. For that we can replace these quantities with its integrals. What is electric flux? Electric flux is the surface integral of the electric field over the surface. And this charge is the volume integral of the charge density rho. Because charge density rho is equal to charge by volume. So, this Q is equal to charge density into volume. If you are taking a small volume dV, then the total charge will be the volume integral of the charge density. So, we have replaced this charge by volume integral of charge density. Now, see this. On the left hand side, we have a surface integral and on the RHS, we have a volume integral. Now, we have to make both LHS and RHS with the same type of integrals. For that, we can use the divergence theorem or Stokes theorem. Here, which theorem is applicable? The relationship between volume integral and surface integral is given by the divergence theorem. That is, volume integral of divergence of a vector is equal to the surface integral of that vector. So, here, in order to apply the divergence theorem here, we don't have a divergence del term here. So, look on this LHS, here the surface integral of only vector. So, the surface integral of only a vector, that is equal to volume integral of divergence of that vector. So, here we can apply the divergence theorem. That is, surface integral of electric field is the volume integral of divergence of the electric field. It is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 volume integral of charge density. Now on the LHS and RHS we have a volume integral. This equation is true for all arbitrary volume. For that the integrants must be equal. So what is the integrand on the left hand side? That is del dot E is equal to integrand on the right hand side is 1 by epsilon 0 constant into rho. So this is the Maxwell's first equation. So Maxwell's first equation is del dot E is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 rho. Rho is the charge density, E is the electric field, epsilon 0 is the permittivity in free space. Now we can consider what will be Maxwell's first equation in the presence of a dielectric medium. Consider a dielectric medium that is placed between two parallel charged plates. That the top plate is positively charged plus Q and bottom plate is negatively charged minus Q. These charges are separated by some distance, so there will be a potential difference and correspondingly an electric field. So here we can say that this dielectric medium is kept in an electric field. Then what will happen within this dielectric medium? In the dielectric medium, if there is no external electric field, the positive and negative center of charges are coincide with each other. That is, if there is no electric field. Now, if an electric field is applied, then what happens is that this positive and negative center of charge will get displaced. Then when this positive and negative charges are get displaced to some distance, that will produce dipoles and thereby an induced dipole moment. This induced dipole moment we can denote as small letter P. So when a dielectric medium is kept in an external electric field, the charges are induced in it. So here also the charges will produce, and the charges will induce such that the positive charge will induce near to this negative plate and negative charge will induce near to the positive plate. So these induced charges we can denote as plus Q dash and minus Q dash. So this plus Q dash and minus Q dash, we can call it as bound charges. Also we can call it as polarization charges. Whereas this plus Q and minus Q, that is called free charge. So the induced charges, that is bound charges or polarization charge, that will produce a charge density, and that charge density is called polarization charge density. Whereas the charge density due to the free charge, that is denoting as rho F, free charge density. What is this polarization charge density? The polarization charge density we can define as the negative of the divergence of polarization vector. What is this polarization? Polarization is induced dipole moment per unit volume. So the induced dipole moment per unit volume is known as polarization, and this phenomenon is called electric polarization. So what is electric polarization? In the absence of an external electric field, the positive and negative center of charges are coincided with each other in the dielectric medium. But in the presence of an external electric field, induced dipoles are produced, and this phenomenon is known as electric polarization, where the polarization is defined as induced dipole moment per unit volume. The induced charges produces a charge density known as polarization charge density or bound charge density, that we are denoting as rho P, that is equal to minus del dot P, where P is the polarization vector. Now we can come to the Maxwell's first equation. We have started from the Gauss's law, that is electric flux is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 times the net charge enclosed within the surface. Here we have replaced this charge by the volume integral of charge density. Now this charge density we can write as the sum of the free charge density and polarization charge density if there is a dielectric medium. So here we are replacing this charge density as the sum of the free charge density and the polarization charge density. So volume integral of rho dv is volume integral of rho f plus rho p dv. Now on the RHS we are applying the divergence theorem. So the surface integral of electric field become volume integral of divergence of the electric field. And again we can write on the right hand side as 1 by epsilon 0 volume integral of rho f plus, what is this polarization charge density? Polarization charge density is the negative of the divergence of polarization vector. So here we can write this rho p as minus del dot p into dv. Now we can split and rearrange this. We can take this epsilon 0 to the LHS. So we will get it as epsilon 0 volume integral of del dot E dv is equal to, here it is volume integral of rho f dv minus volume integral of del dot P dv. Here we can combine the divergence term on the LHS and the divergence term on the RHS. So here it is volume integral of epsilon 0 is a constant. So we can take this epsilon 0 along with this electric field. So that is del dot epsilon 0 E plus, here also we have a del dot P dv. So on taking this term to the LHS is become plus volume integral of del dot P dv, and that divergence also we are taking common. So what we will get? Plus polarization vector into dv, that is volume integral of divergence of epsilon 0 E plus P dv, and on the RHS it is volume integral of rho f dv. Here the quantity epsilon 0 E plus P, that is called electric displacement vector, and we can denote it as capital letter D. It is called electric displacement vector. So this expression become volume integral of del dot D is equal to the volume integral of free charge density. Now see this, on the LHS and RHS both we have the volume integral with an arbitrary volume. So for this equation to be true, the integrands must be equal. So on equating these integrals, what we will get? On the LHS, the integrand is del dot D, and on the RHS, the integrand is rho f. So this is the differential form of this Maxwell's first equation in the presence of a dielectric medium. Here D is the electric displacement vector given by epsilon 0 E plus P. So Maxwell's first equation is del dot E equal to 1 by epsilon 0 rho that we have derived first. And if you are taking the polarization effects there, then the equation is del dot D is equal to rho f. Rho f is the free charge density, D is the electric displacement vector. Next is Maxwell's second equation. Here we are using Gauss's law in magnetostatics. It states that the total magnetic flux over any closed surface is zero. That is phi b is equal to zero. What is this magnetic flux over a surface? That is the surface integral of the magnetic field over that surface. On the LHS, we can apply divergence theorem. What is divergence theorem? The volume integral of divergence of a vector is equal to surface integral of that vector. So here the surface integral of the vector B is equal to volume integral of the divergence of that vector, that is volume integral of del dot B dv is equal to zero. For this volume integral to be zero, the integrand must vanish. That means the integrand del dot B is equal to zero. So del dot B is equal to zero is the Maxwell's second equation in the differential form. So first equation we have seen that del dot E is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 rho, and second equation is del dot B is equal to 0. Why there is a dissimilarity between the divergence of this electric field and magnetic field there? Here, in the case of electric field, isolated charges can exist. It is possible that one positive charges alone or one negative charges alone. That is, isolated charges can exist. But in magnetism, magnetic monopoles do not exist. That's why this del dot B is equal to zero. So this Maxwell's second equation signifies that magnetic monopoles do not exist. That's why there is a dissimilarity between the Maxwell's first and second equation. Isolated charges can exist, but magnetic monopoles do not exist. Next, we can see Maxwell's third equation. It is based on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's law states that if we have a closed loop of wire and the magnetic flux link with that wire is changing, that will induce an EMF. This induced EMF will be equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux link with it. And also this induced EMF opposes that change in the magnetic flux. That is, induced EMF produced in a closed loop of wire is equal to the rate of change of magnetic flux linked with it, and also that direction is opposite to that change in the magnetic flux. So induced EMF E is equal to minus d phi b by dt. So we have written this Faraday's law in the mathematical form. Now we can express this mathematical form in terms of some integrals. For that, we can write this induced EMF as the integral form and also this magnetic flux as some integral form. So this induced EMF E is equal to the line integral of the electric field, because the potential we can write as the line integral of electric field. So here if we have a closed loop of wire and the dl is a small line element there, then the induced EMF produced in this closed loop of wire due to the change in the magnetic flux is equal to the line integral of the electric field associated with it, where E is the intensity of the electric field associated with this closed loop of wire due to the change in the magnetic flux. Also, we can express this magnetic flux as the surface integral of the magnetic field over the surface. So this phi b is surface integral of magnetic field and this induced EMF is the line integral of the electric field. So we can write these expressions here. This induced EMF is the line integral of the electric field, then this RHS becomes minus d by dt of phi b is surface integral of the magnetic field over the surface. Now on the LHS we have a line integral and on the RHS we have a surface integral. Now we have to make both the LHS and the RHS with the same type of integral. So which theorem is connecting this line integral and the surface integral? That is Stokes' theorem. What is Stokes' theorem? Stokes' theorem is surface integral of curl of a vector is equal to the line integral of that vector. So here we can apply Stokes' theorem on LHS. According to Stokes' theorem, this line integral of this electric field vector become the surface integral of the curl of that vector. So surface integral of del cross E is equal to, on the RHS we have differentiation and integration acting on the same magnetic field vector. If the differentiation and the integrations are simultaneously acting on a vector, we can interchange that order of differentiation and the integration. That means first we can put the integration, then we can put the differentiation. So here first we are writing the integration, then we are taking the differentiation into this. When we are taking the full derivative inside of this integration, we can also change this as the partial derivative. So this becomes minus integral of dou by dou t of b ds. Now, after the application of the Stokes theorem on the LHS and the RHS, both we got the surface integral. So, that is true for any fixed surface. So, for that, the integrants must be equal. What is the integrant on the LHS? That is del cross E. And the integrant on the RHS is minus dou B by dou T. So, this is the Maxwell's third equation. Curl of the electric field is equal to minus dou B by dou T. So, the Maxwell's third equation is del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. It is based on Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. That means an electric field can also be generated by a time varying magnetic field. If the magnetic field is not varying, that is if it is a static field, what will be this expression? Del cross E is equal to 0. Next is Maxwell's fourth equation. It is based on the Ampere's circuital law. Ampere's law states that the line integral of the magnetic field around any closed path, which is equal to the mu 0 times the current enclosed within the path. So, the mathematical expression for it is line integral of B dl is equal to mu 0 I. On the LHS already we have a line integral term. So, on the RHS we can change it into some integral form. So, what is the term in the RHS? That is current. Current we can write as the surface integral of current density, where J is the current density. So, this expression becomes mu 0 I e surface integral of J ds. So, on the LHS we have a line integral and on the RHS we have a surface integral. So, we have to make both LHS and RHS as same type of integral. For that, which theorem we can apply? What is the theorem connecting the line integral and surface integral? That is Stokes' theorem. What is Stokes' theorem? The surface integral of the curl of a vector is equal to the line integral of that vector. So, on the LHS, we can apply Stokes' theorem and we can write this line integral of this magnetic field as surface integral of curl of the magnetic field. So, surface integral of del cross B is equal to mu 0 times the surface integral of the current density. Now, on the LHS and RHS both we have surface integral. So, it is true for any fixed surface. For that, the integrant must be equal. What's the integrant on the LHS? That is del cross B, which is equal to the integrant on the RHS is mu 0, that is constant, into current density. So, this is Maxwell's fourth equation. So, the Maxwell's fourth equation is curl B is equal to mu 0 J. Also, we can write this B as mu 0 H. Mu 0 is the permeability in free space. H is the magnetic field intensity. So, here this del cross B become mu 0 H. Then this mu 0 and mu 0 will cancel and we will get it as del cross H is equal to J. So, this Maxwell's fourth equation also we can represent as del cross H is equal to J. But this equation holds good for steady currents only. Why this Maxwell's fourth equation del cross B equal to mu 0 J hold good only for steady currents, that is for static currents, that we can see. Our Maxwell's fourth equation now got is del cross B is equal to mu 0 J. Now we can take the divergence of this equation. So, on taking divergence on the LHS, that is del dot acting on this del cross B, and also take divergence on RHS, that is del dot mu 0 J. On the LHS, here we have divergence of curl of a vector. What is divergence of curl of a vector? That is 0, that we have seen in one previous video. The divergence of curl is equal to 0. So, this LHS becomes 0 is equal to, on the RHS mu 0 is constant that we are taking outside. So, it becomes del dot J, that is mu 0 del dot J is equal to 0. Mu 0 is a constant that cannot be 0. So, what can be 0 there? Del dot J is equal to 0. What is this del dot J? That we have seen in the equation of continuity. So, according to equation of continuity, del dot J is equal to minus dou rho by dou t. That means this Virchow's B equal to mu 0 J, the Maxwell's fourth equation, is valid when this del dot J becomes 0. When this del dot J becomes 0, that is applicable only for steady currents, that is for stationary currents. This charge density is constant. That time this dou rho by dou t is equal to 0 and we will get del dot J is equal to 0. That is del dot J equal to 0 hold good only for steady currents. That means this Virchow's B equal to mu 0 J is hold good for the case of steady currents. So if the current is not steady, that is if the electric field is varying, then we have to modify this Maxwell's fourth equation. So next we are going to modify this Maxwell's fourth equation. Now, where we required the correction in this expression, here del cross B equal to mu 0 J. So, we required the correction in the current density term, because according to equation of continuity, del dot J equal to minus dou rho by dou t. But from this Maxwell's fourth equation, we got del dot J as 0. So, correction is required in the J term. So, how can we make the correction? For that, we can consider the Maxwell's first equation. Maxwell's first equation is del dot E is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 rho. Or we can write it as rho is equal to epsilon 0 del dot E. So using this, we can write the equation of continuity as del dot J is equal to minus dou by dou t of rho is epsilon 0 del dot E. On the LHS and the RHS, both we have the divergence term. So we can take it together. Then what we are getting, it become del dot J. We can take this RHS to the LHS by taking del as outside. So it become J plus, this minus become plus epsilon 0. The remaining term is dou by dou t of E. That is equal to 0. Now see this. This is the corrected current density. Earlier according to this equation we got del dot J equal to 0. Now this is del dot J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. That is an extra term epsilon 0 dou E by dou T is required along with the current density J. So this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T we can write as JD and it is called displacement current density. So we can introduce this displacement current density in the previous fourth equation. So fourth equation becomes del cross B is equal to mu 0 J we can write as J plus JD. Where JD is the displacement current density. How this displacement current density is produced? That is due to the time varying electric field. So del cross B is equal to mu 0 J plus JD, that is displacement current density, is epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. So Maxwell's corrected fourth equation is del cross B is equal to mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. J is the current density due to the moving charges. But this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T is the displacement current density. That is not due to the moving charges. It is due to the time varying electric field. Here this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T we can also write as dou D by dou T, where this D is the electric displacement vector. We have seen this electric displacement vector in the Maxwell's first equation as epsilon 0 E plus P. So there we have considered this polarization P in the presence of dielectric. So if it is in the free space, then it becomes D is equal to epsilon 0 E. Otherwise, if it is in the dielectric medium, then we can say that this becomes epsilon E, where epsilon is epsilon 0 epsilon R in the presence of a dielectric medium. Here we have considering the free space, then we can write this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T as dou D by dou T, because epsilon 0 E is the electric displacement vector D. So also we can write this Maxwell's fourth equation as del cross B is equal to mu 0 J plus this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T is dou D by dou T, where D is the electric displacement vector. If we are writing in terms of H, then B is equal to mu 0 H, then the expression becomes del cross H is equal to this mu 0 and LHS and RHS will cancel and we will get it as J plus dou D by dou T. So these are the various forms of Maxwell's fourth equation. So if the current is steady, then the Maxwell's fourth equation is del cross B equal to mu 0 J. Otherwise, if the electric field is varying, due to the time varying electric field, there is another current produced that is known as displacement current. And hence the displacement current density that is equal to epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. That epsilon 0 dou E by dou T also we can write as dou D by dou T. So we have seen four Maxwell's equations. The first equation is based on Gauss's law in electrostatics and the differential form of that equation is del dot E is equal to 1 by epsilon 0 rho. If you are considering the polarization effects in the dielectric medium, then del dot D is equal to rho F. Then we can write it in the integral form as surface integral of this electric displacement vector is equal to charge. Also we can write this Q as the volume integral of charge density. And second Maxwell's equation is based on Gauss's law for magnetism, that is del dot B is equal to 0 and its integral form is surface integral of magnetic field is equal to 0. Then third equation is based on Faraday's law, that is curl E is equal to minus dou B by dou T and its integral form is the line integral of electric field is minus surface integral of the dou B by dou T. And the fourth equation is based on Ampere's law. The differential form is del cross B equal to mu 0 J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T. This epsilon 0 dou E by dou T also we can write as dou D by dou T because epsilon 0 E is the electric displacement vector. If you are writing it in terms of the magnetic field intensity H, this expression becomes J plus epsilon 0 dou E by dou T because mu 0 on both sides will cancel. And the integral form is line integral of magnetic field is equal to mu 0 times the surface integral of J plus this epsilon 0 dou E by dou T, that is dou D by dou T. So these are all about Maxwell's four equations. These Maxwell's equations represent the fundamentals of electricity and magnetism in a very concise way. The first equation gives that the charge distribution can generate an electric field. Second equation gives that the magnetic flux over a surface is zero and that signifies that the magnetic monopoles do not exist. And third equation gives that a time varying magnetic field can generate an electric field. And fourth equation gives that a time varying electric field can generate a magnetic field. Okay, that's all about Maxwell's four equations. Okay.